It's a Chromebook Benchmark Shootout. Okay, so we're going to have a wee go at a bit of a Chromebook Shootout here. We have three Chromebooks, as you can see. Small, large, and medium, I guess. At the start, we have the Acer. It's not the R11, that's actually the C720. That was my original Chromebook. I've had that for about 4 years. Was bought for about $190 out in the States. It's worked very well. I have upgraded it solely for the SSD. Went from 16 gigabytes up to, well, I put I think I put about 100 gigabytes in. There's 91 gigabytes free, so that's all it's had. It's still on the 2 gigabytes of RAM, and it has an Intel Celeron 1.4 inside of it. Not the best, but still actually quite competent. Not fully supported, but I have noticed the odd little update come over, so it's got some kind of Chrome support for updates or security or whatever. This is an Acer Chromebook 14. This is the Intel Celeron version. It has, I think it's got 16 gigabytes of onboard storage and 2 gigabytes of RAM. So it's fairly similar to the C720 over there. This costs about £200 to buy new. It's a good looking big screen device with a matte display and a large exciting touchpad there. It's a good looking device, I have to say. And then the creme de la creme, my upgrade to this is the Acer R-13. Now this has the MediaTek processor inside it with 4 gigabytes of RAM and 64 gigabytes of storage. So it's not as fast as maybe some of the Asuses that you see with an i5 or an i3 inside or one of the Pixelbooks, but it's modestly priced at about £300. So I think it's a good comparative to have with these other ones, because this is currently on sale for £200. This is currently on sale for £300, and there is a variant of this that is currently on sale. But in legacy, for legacy reasons, I think the outcome of the benchmarking on this will be quite interesting when you compare it to this and this. So we've got Speedometer up, which is one of the better benchmarking tools at the moment on the Chromebook. Octane was discontinued, so we're having to go with one of the ones that actually I think Google themselves on the Chromium blog recommend you use. So I'm just going to hit start test and let them run and examine the scores, because the highest will be best and the lowest will be the worst. And depending on how long it takes, I might speed it up or slow it down, and you should be able to get a general gist of just how fast things are. Okay, for example, we have a speedometer test on here of 68.9, which is a fairly decent score apparently. And what we're just going to run across each of them and go pop 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 and get them all running. So the R13, the Chromebook 14, and the Acer C720. Just hit it. Okay, so they've all finished, and we have some interesting results. So starting at this end, we have a score of 29.92. This is the newest model, featuring the MediaTek 2.10 GHz quad-core processor and 4 GB of DDR3 RAM. Now, I guess you could say that it's doing a few things in the background, updating notifications and things. We have one notification of a YouTube video that's available to watch, But other than that, this is what we have. 29.92 runs per minute. Then over here, we have the Acer Chromebook 14, which is the biggest of the lot. Both of these have 1080p screens. It's probably worth mentioning that. This managed 20.4, which seems a little low, perhaps. And then again, it's got the Celeron dual core 1.6 gigahertz with only 2 gigabytes of RAM. So we're noticing the difference here, 4 gigabytes of RAM, 2 gigabytes of RAM, and the 16 gigabytes of SSD, but that shouldn't make a difference, but the storage doesn't really come into effect here. Now over at the end, we have the 4, possibly 5 year old Acer C720. Running a 1.4 gigahertz dual core Celeron processor, slightly slower than this one. 2 gigabytes of DDR3 RAM, slightly slower than this one. Yet it only has a 1366 by 768 screen. So whilst these two are 1080p, this one is essentially 720. A wee bit more than 720, but 720. And that must make a big difference because that score is 38.06, almost double what that is, and a third more than what this is. That's a little bit worrying. However, this is a browser benchmark, so obviously it doesn't really take into account all of the specifications of the PC. It is merely its ability to render the web pages and all that kind of stuff and run the tasks. But when you compare this to some of the other devices out there, it does seem to be quite slow, especially given that this is, well, actually both of these are still for sale, £200 and £300. This isn't sold anymore. It's the best of the bunch. Now, this is Speedometer 1.0, so I'm going to go ahead and have a go at Speedometer 2.0. Okay, it looks exactly the same, but it does say Speedometer 2.0 up here as opposed to 1.0. So let's see how we do with this. Alright, okay, so we've got a result here for Speedometer 2.0. Again, the C720 appears to kick ass. There's 21.3 over there. It's closely, well, somewhat closely, followed by the R-13, which is 15.9, and then lagging way behind, and it took almost half an hour for that to run, is the Chromebook 14 at 11.1. Inside that time, whilst sitting here drumming my fingers and waiting patiently for it to eventually finish, I had a quick look at some of the other scores available online, and the 2017 iPad Pro manages 77.2. An i7 running Chrome version 63 gets 123.2. So for browser-based computers, you would expect to have some kind of wonderful browser-based score hitting home, because there's not much else running here. A PC or a MacBook or a phone would have a bunch of different things happening in the background, yet they still mop the floor of these three, and it's the C720 that comes out tops over these two newer Acer models. This was one of the first Chromebooks on the block, and looks like it's still one of the best when it comes to budget buys. You can't buy that anymore. £200, £300. This should have done a lot better. Now, obviously, this isn't the best way to test the Chromebook. It's about the only way that we can, because you can't really download. You can download web kits and things like that and have things running like that. But for a quick flash in the pan bookmark shootout like this, this appears to be one of the best ways. And comparing it to bigger, bolder computers, you'll get massively different results. So hopefully this has been of some use to a couple of people out there who would tune in and watch this. The R13 is my day bag battler. The C720 is now taking up a permanent residence in the office and not being used anymore. It just turns off as I say that. The Chromebook 14 is thankfully going back to Acer at the earliest convenience, because it is horrible to have to try and use, because it is that slow. I'm finding, aside from the actual look of it, there's very little that I can actually recommend about this particular Chromebook. There are far better options out there. And then this R13 works quite well. The screen is lovely and the build quality is lovely, but these scores are pretty upsetting whenever you think about it, that this is one of the current generation and it's performing that poorly on the surface. So let me know if you have any questions down below. Give us a wee thumbs up if you fancy. Hit that subscribe button. And other than that, take care.